Let's go. Let's go. I had to take bombshell with the... Don't worry, my brother's from another sister. I'm not about to tell you to hold hands around a campfire and yell affirmations for each other while whining about life and how terrible you feel. Vulnerability is often associated with weakness, especially to traditional men. And modern culture has absolutely washed the meaning of vulnerability. They make it this excuse to whine, to become wimpy, soft, and squishy men who use their emotions as reasons to act in self-serving, pathetic ways. Which, let's be honest, none of us have respect for those people. Being vulnerable doesn't mean you become an emotionally volatile person, or someone who makes decisions based on how they feel. Being vulnerable is to willingly put yourself in situations where you think that you could be rejected. Do things which doesn't require the approval of anyone. This means to tell jokes that people might not find funny, asserting your opinions even though you could be wrong, introducing yourself to people you don't know, or even telling a woman that you like her and wish to date her. Doing these things require you to put your pride and dignity on the line, risking shame and heaps of perceived negative emotions. But learning to become vulnerable gives you tremendous power. Imagine the immense surplus of opportunities you have, people you will meet and connect with, opportunities of potential mates, and moments of fulfillment and meaning. A vulnerable man is someone who screams, "This is who I am, this is who I want to be, and nothing you throw at me can make me abandon who I am." Let's put it this way, there are two men. One stands tall, looks straight ahead, looks people in the eye when he speaks to them, allowing them to stare into his soul, and he's comfortable with them noticing things he could be insecure about. He says what he thinks, and is unfazed if people disagree with him. He tells jokes that he finds funny, even if the situation could be awkward. He expresses his emotions, even if it means he'll be rejected, and he shrugs off or apologizes when he makes mistakes. He isn't afraid to be playful around anyone, even if they could be uncomfortable and think of him in a negative way. The second man has a closed-off body posture. His eyes dart around while talking to someone because he gets uncomfortable. He puts on a cool persona and acts cold to people to reflect some sort of competence. He avoids saying things that could upset people, lies to avoid conflict, and is always trying to impress people. When he makes mistakes, he starts trying to defend himself and make excuses for it. He might blame others or pretend it never happened. He hides his emotions and tells people he's fine even when he's not, because he thinks people could leave him since he's too much of a burden. When he is rejected, he gets angry and desperate, and finds ways to win back the affection of that person. Which man is more attractive? Which man do you admire more? Which man is more vulnerable? Men who aren't vulnerable are constantly reactive to other men around them. They don't admit faults. They change their behavior and what they say to win the approval of other men. They look to blame others and constantly try to cover up their weaknesses. This reflects low status. They will appear untrustworthy and not confident. Vulnerable men are unfazed by the behavior of these men. They focus on their tasks and don't have the need to change their behavior based on what others think of them. When challenged, they stand up for themselves. When they're in the wrong, they will admit their fault because they see no reason to hide their weaknesses. They are liberated from pressure to act in certain ways, while the men who are not vulnerable have to act around them, have to act according to these vulnerable men, which gives vulnerable men ultimate power. Making these changes will be incredibly difficult. You are trying to alter lifelong habits, so don't expect it to be easy. Your room is literally filled with 5 years of cum stains. It's going to feel like the more you overcome, the more retarded things you find out you don't really like about yourself. Becoming a vulnerable man from being once a needy man is no easy task. You're going to constantly face all your fears, anxieties, and stresses every single day, every single hour. It's consistent confrontation of yourself. It's going to be frustrating, confusing, and goddamn painful at times. But after a few months, you will begin to reap its benefits. People will open up to you more. People are going to want to speak to you more. People are going to smile at you more, praise you for your honesty, and they will express their respect for you because you'll be putting yourself in situations they don't dare to put themselves in. In the past, the image of somebody potentially hating me or disliking me could very well keep me awake at night, and I would autistically strategize how I can win back their affection, how I can start conversations with them, maybe find out what they like and pretend I like it too, so that they can relate with me and we can become good friends. My life revolved around people pleasing, hiding my mistakes, trying to be morally right all the time, so that I could maximize my likability. It's very difficult because you will watch countless people around you who didn't have to willingly walk head on into their anxieties and fears every single day, like you are doing. And yet, They get way more opportunities than you do. This is simply because they didn't experience the traumatic experiences you've been through to become a needy man. So when they started off in social environments, they kind of already fit straight into place because they were lucky in some sort. You just have to learn to let go of that anger. Keep on casting yourself into the deep end. The world will give back to you in tiny ways and you will notice them. Become mindful of every decision you make. Are they out of fear? What are your intentions? They should be to pleasure yourself, to take you one step closer to the person you wish to become. What are you stopping yourself from doing? Becoming vocal in public? Confronting a friend? Expressing how you feel about something? Sharing about yourself? The less you talk about your shame, the more of it you will have. I think meditating is a great way to start. Be mindful of all your interactions. Deliberately start pushing and seeing how far you can go out of your comfort zone. How big of a risk of rejection can you take? As you keep deliberately chasing discomfort and keep putting yourself out there and keep doing even the littlest things that could risk rejection, like asking a question in class or introducing yourself to someone you don't know, eventually you will actually be rejected in some situations and you realize, wait a minute, that wasn't that bad. That wasn't bad at all. I did what I wanted to do and the repercussions don't faze me at all, because being who you want to be, presenting yourself openly means more to you than that rejection, and you'll be proud of yourself, and you should be. This fear of potential rejection is habitual. It is something we thought we needed to survive while growing up. Maybe going against instructions or making mistakes when you were younger caused you to face terrible consequences. It caused you to panic and it caused you to go through a lot of pain. And maybe that's why you started to develop habitual fear towards this rejection. Maybe when you asked a lot of questions, people found you annoying and that hurt. And maybe you were pushed away a lot whenever you had needs. That's why you started to habitually develop this immense fear towards this perceived negative experience, which is rejection. But as you put yourself out there more, as you welcome the rejection with open arms and understand you value who you want to be that much more, you become powerful. You become less cynical, less resentful. You realize who you truly are, what you truly want out of life. You realize that nobody really cares, and being rejected actually causes you zero harm, and you were never truly afraid of it. You're going to start actually making some genuine relationships, start finding people you can count on, and soon enough you'll feel immense regret. I cannot believe I spent so much time pondering about so many useless things that held me back from being who I want to be, from chasing the opportunities I was given and stepping into the experiences I wish to have. Imperfections, mistakes, and insufficiencies are what makes you magnetic. When you hear girls talk about how cute a guy is, of course naturally they love the confidence, the competence, and the attractiveness, but they also love to glamorize their imperfections and their strange eccentricities. That's what people will talk about because it makes you human. And I find that many people will try to pick and choose and be selective about their quirkiness, what they want to show, what weird parts of them they think that could be magnetic, and they will only show those parts instead of becoming entirely open. The thing is, if you pick and choose, that reflects the need for approval and attention. People aren't stupid. For the most part anyway. Some people might still fall for that, but we don't want a stupid wife, do we? If not, she'll just fall for any guy who acts like he's competent. People can see right through and see exactly what you're trying to do. But when you're open entirely and you express how you feel about your eccentricities, they can also recognize when it's genuine. I know you wasted so much time being needy, feeling pathetic, constantly evaluating every action you make, how you appear and every word you say, to optimize how much you're liked by others. It feels like such a huge portion of our lives is wasted, trying to be someone we're not, just so that we could be accepted by people. But this need to be accepted, this fear of abandonment and rejection, is absolutely suffocating. The anxiousness, the worry, the fear, the sleepless nights, the loneliness, the wishing you don't push yet another person away. Let us let go. Let us become strong, vulnerable men who fight for themselves and their tribe, who isn't afraid of being shunned, who smiles in the face of defeat. We're going to express ourselves however we want, and people are going to mock us, and we're going to stand there, unfazed. Build your character, let your identity and passion envelop the world around you. When you become comfortable in taking damage, when you let go of your fear, your need to impress, your need to be right, as you willingly act as the person you wish to be, no matter what the repercussions are, funny enough, the more vulnerable you become, the closer to invulnerability you get. You become confident, you become attractive, you become a force to be reckoned with, you become something of substance, a man who stands for what he believes in, even if it means standing alone, a strong, capable, charismatic man who gets what he wants out of life, a man who has genuine relationships, who is trustworthy, respected, and admired. Becoming vulnerable is a life-altering experience. Being vulnerable is what being yourself actually means. Don't let anyone take away from or shape who you want to be. Be comfortable in rejection. Be comfortable in being tossed away and abandoned. Whatever happens, you handle it and you're going to be okay. It's our time now. To a better world.
You're on my wall now. Leave more comments and I'll flood my wall. with ego boost. Thank you.